direct selling companies are commonly misunderstood and often mixed with Ponzi, pyramid, or get-rich-quick schemes. This is especially true in emerging markets where the direct selling industry is less regulated and governed by inadequate regulations, consumer protections, etc. Well, today we're debunking the myths from passion to profit, how one global company is leading the way in direct sales, and it starts at the top. Join us virtually are Malou, Caluza, QNET CEO, and Arun George, QNET's top distributor. Welcome, guys. Thank you so much for joining us today. Malou, you started out at QNET over 20 years ago as the company's first receptionist, and now you're running the business. You've seen it grow from a struggling startup to a global entity.
Thank you, Montel. When I first started with the company, we were just a small group of people, and everyone was involved in everything. There was no employee manual or list of SOPs to follow. What we actually did was to just learn and build as we go. I saw how dedicated the founders were to the business, employees, and to our customers. They were also involved in everything from presenting the business, handling the customers, to managing inventory, to packing our product. Seeing them like that made a big impression on me, and that's where I learned the true meaning of service.
QNET is one of the few Asian direct selling companies to have made inroads into the number of new and emerging markets around the world. What do you think sets QNET apart?
I think one of the smartest things our founders, Vijay Eswaran and Joseph Bismarck, did back in the late 90s was to merge the well-established concept of direct selling with the then fairly new concept of e-commerce. This definitely disrupted traditional direct selling, which at the time was all about personal face-to-face interactions, establishing retail shops, and home-based parties. So we've experienced some challenges, but we had a lot of excitement and passion and belief into what we were doing, and the experiment paid off. The other interesting trend we tap into is a rise in micro-entrepreneurship. The gig economy that everyone is talking about today is popularized by tech companies, but direct selling was the original gig economy business.
Certainly sounds like a great opportunity. Let's bring in Arun George, your top distributor. How did you get involved in this, and what's your journey been like, Arun?
Thanks, Montel. It definitely has been a very exciting journey so far, you know, plenty of ups and downs. I actually got involved with direct selling at the age of 23, just a couple of years after graduating from college. And QNET is the first and the only direct selling company I've done business with. I was born and raised in India, and then I moved to Middle East looking for better career opportunities. Now, I looked at the products of the company, great products. I could hardly see any downside to it. So I decided to, you know, get started. And I made the decision to give it my best, at least during that first 1 year. And soon the business started taking off. I was able to build the organization into a few other countries in the Middle East. I moved to the United States with my family so that I could give better opportunities to my kids. And today, 20 years later, I have this global organization growing in about 40 different countries.
Well, now look, you sell a wide range of products from wellness to technology, holidays to health, watches and jewelry. We have some of your products right here, some of your best sellers. And it is really, really great stuff.
Yes. Our distributors are present in many different regions around the world, Montel. That's why we offer a diverse portfolio to suit different demographics. We work with international vendors to design unique, high-quality, and advanced technology items that can only be found at QNET. Our home care products are my personal favorites. I am a cancer survivor, and it is really important for me to use products in my home that will keep me and my family safe and healthy. We have this fantastic 9-stage water purification system that runs without electricity and a beautifully designed air purifier with a 5-stage filtration system. And most recently, we launched a completely natural weight management product called Belite.
You know, I love the Bernard H. Meyer and Sinier range of watches from QNET. They are handcrafted by master craftsmen in Switzerland. QNET is a sponsor of the Manchester City Football Club, which plays in the English Premier League. And QNET has launched a limited edition Sinier QNET City watch last year to commemorate the partnership between the two brands.
So, Arun, what is the most common misconception people have about direct selling? And what do you say to those who doubt the legitimacy of the business?
I hear these questions no matter which country I'm in. I don't blame them. even I had these concerns when I was introduced to this concept years back. So what I help people understand is that, you know, there's something called as direct sales and network marketing, and then there is something called as pyramiding and Ponzi schemes, and they're not one and the same. The challenge, though, is the lack of awareness, as well as a lack of legal framework in many emerging economies that helps public to differentiate between the genuine direct selling businesses and the fraudulent pyramid schemes. So when there are crackdowns by authorities, the genuine companies get grouped with these short-term schemes, and the narrative that the public reads in the news is that there is this rise in a fraudulent pyramid scheme.
So thank you both for joining us today.
Thank you, Montel.
Thank you so much, Montel.
Yes, please visit our website, qnet.net, which has all the information you need about the company.
Absolutely. And you know what you got to do if you want more information? All you have to do is go to our website, thebalancingact.com. We'll be back right after this.